book lovers. It is G-Swizz here, and I'm here today with my 5-star predictions. So if you didn't know, this is a 7 on Sunday topic, and I'm the host of 7 on Sunday. I will link the Goodreads page down in the description where you can check it out, and you can participate in a topic in the future, or you can suggest a topic. And I used to be strictly against 5-star prediction videos, because as soon as I film them, and as soon as I have a 5-star prediction for a book, I, majority of the time, just so happen to be disappointed. I used to make like low-star predictions videos, and I'm thinking of doing that eventually again. I just want to be able to talk about the books I have low expectations for, because I notice when I talk about that topic somewhere and then I end up eventually reading the book, I just so happen to be very surprised by the outcome. With my 5-star predictions, however, sometimes these books end up being like, I don't know, a 4 out of 5 stars or maybe even somewhat lower, but every once in a while there is a book that just so happens to wow me from the bunch. Like this time last year, I did mention that The War of Lost Hearts was on my 5-star predictions list. At first, I read the book and I was like, oh, this is a 4 stars, but it grew on me and I could not stop thinking about it. Like the book lived in my mind rent free. So I bumped it up to a 5 stars, and I'd say that that's probably my most successful book or series on my 5-star predictions. But majority of the time, the 5-star predictions end up being like a solid 4. However, I guess the purpose of this video is to talk about the books that you have a really good feeling about, and the books that I'm going to mention today, I have a really good feeling about. I don't know if I own every single one of these books as of yet, but I've decided to put all of these on my 5-star predictions. And it was really hard for me to predict what books on my physical TBR would make my 5-star predictions list. So I decided to go off of a list that consists of books that I do physically own, but books that I am currently planning to buy. So I guess without further ado, let's get straight into this list where I talk about the books I have 5-star predictions for. First and foremost, I have 5-star predictions for The Night Duet or The Nightborn Duet by Carissa Broadbent. And yes, that consists of The Serpent and the Wings of Night and The Ashes and the Star Cursed King. Now I actually specifically waited to put this on my March TBR so that I could talk about this specific book series on my 5-star predictions list. I think out of all the books in the series on this list, this one has the highest chance of making a 5 out of 5 star book series. And that is because Carissa Broadbent has proven herself once to me. She'll prove herself again. Like, I feel as if I can almost guarantee it. I think that's also because I have work colleagues who absolutely love and adore this book series and talk about it constantly. I don't think I've met a single person in my life who has hated this book or the series in general. And to top it all off, I absolutely adored The War of Lost Hearts. So I decided that this book series was gonna make my 5-star predictions list. I've talked about this book series being on my TBR a lot, so I don't really need to elaborate here, but I definitely think it's gonna be a favorite, and I've been putting it off for a while. I'm planning to get to it in March. We'll see how I go. And the next book that I've placed on my 5-star predictions list is Jennifer L. Armentrout's Fall of Ruin and Wrath. I initially had no expectations for this book whatsoever, and then for some reason I decided, you know what, I was gonna reread The Dark Elements and the Harbinger series. And I think for a long time I've been in this Blood and Ash bubble, because yes, Jennifer has written the Blood and Ash series and it's like her most popular series at the moment, but rereading the Harbinger trilogy specifically reminded me just how good Jennifer's other stories are. And additionally, I also read The Covenant Saga last year and I absolutely adored it. I love so many of Jennifer L. Armentrout's books. I've read so many books by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I think she is probably my most read author at the moment. I could be wrong, but I mean, I plan to talk about that sometime later this month. Hey, Fall of Ruin and Wrath, I believe, has the potential to absolutely wow me. I am so excited for this first book in a new series. I barely know anything about it, but what I do know is that it seems to be pretty fleshed out based on the page count, and also Tor/Bramble picked it up. You know, they picked up The Serpent and the Wings of Night as well. I just have a feeling, based on the fact that it's been picked up by its specific publisher, that a good publishing team has worked on this book with Jennifer, and because it is a new adult book series written by Jennifer that's not set within the Blood and Ash world, I can kind of go into this book series with an open mind. I have very high expectations for this book. I really hope I love it. If I don't necessarily adore it, and if I give it like a 4 out of 5 stars, I'll still be okay with that as well, considering I know nothing about the book's premise whatsoever. I just reckon that Jennifer could surprise me in a new way, and I think that this book series does have the potential to do that. Lol. Okay, I've put The Spider's Mate Trilogy by Tiffany Roberts on my 5-star predictions TBR. And to the arachnophobes out there, no, I don't have any regrets, okay? Tiffany Roberts have proven to be one of my favorite author duos ever. I love their stories. I find their stories to be absolutely wholesome and comforting, but they are usually such a great adventure as well. I do trust their ability to write a good sci-fi romance, and I believe that the Spider's Mate series is a sci-fi romance. I mean, based on the fact that it takes place on a different planet and we're following spider aliens and stuff, but I just love the overall message of Tiffany Roberts' books overall. I don't know what to expect from the whole like spider's planet thing, but just based on the fact that we have more time to spend with these characters, because honestly, like, as much as I have been enjoying Tiffany Roberts' books, the fact that the books that I've read from them have been either standalone or companion novels has kind of just like really bugged me, because as much as I love those stories, I just want more time with the characters. And I think this series has potential to be a 5 out of 5 star book series because we are spending 3 books with these characters. And I honestly think overall that that will make a huge difference in me being invested in the story and just enjoying a Tiffany Roberts adventure in general. So I've put this trilogy on my 5-star predictions TBR. I am not going to specify that the first book is going to be a 5 out of 5 stars. I should have also mentioned that with Serpent and the Wings of Night as well. I would expect the later books in the series to be a higher rating than the first book. So when it comes to The Spider's Mate, if the first book's 4 out of 5 stars, then that's good. But if like the later books in the series are 5 out of 5 stars, I will consider that as a prediction for me. I usually just expect series to gradually get better. And the next 5-star prediction that I've placed in this list today is A Kingdom of Flame and Fury by Whitney Dean. I've wanted to read the series for a while, but the length of the books are intimidating. And for some reason, whenever I look at a thick fantasy romance, I have a feeling it might just be a 5 out of 5 stars if I see majority of the reviews being positive. Like, I would usually expect maybe, I don't know, like a 300 to a 350 page romance book to be like a solid 4 out of 5 stars. But if I see something that's over 500 pages that's getting many amazing rave reviews, I expect it to be a 5 out of 5 star book. And if the first book is not a 5 out of 5 star book, similarly to what I've said previously, then I do kind of predict that the later books will be. I mean, the third book in the series is like 700 or 800 pages, you know? If I am not absolutely loving the series at that point, there is something wrong with me and I would just need to DNF it, essentially. But I am just overall expecting this book series to be absolutely incredible. That's just my personal opinion. I really hope that I'm proven right. And the next 5-star prediction I have to mention today is The Trials of the Sun Queen. I really want to love this book because I've heard absolutely great things about this book, and I have a work colleague who absolutely adores this book. I just know that this is like Hunger Games meets The Selection, but it's new adult and it got picked up by a publisher and the covers look absolutely stunning, but I don't know anything much more than that. But what I will say is that I'm still a sucker for Hunger Games comps, even though I feel as if I should be moved past that point. I mean, I'm a 28-year-old, right? I would expect myself to just not want to read the Hunger Games comps because they sound too YA-like. No, I'm a sucker for a good Hunger Games comp and no one can change my mind there. I just absolutely adore the concept of it. But this one does not seem as intense as the Hunger Games because it also got comped to The Selection. And The Selection is a cool concept. I did not like The Selection series specifically, but I like the concept of The Selection. So I reckon that The Trials of the Sun Queen is gonna be a good time. And the next 5-star prediction that I have on this list today is a book I've been seeing everywhere in the dark romance booktubenet. And that, my friends, is The Book of Azrael. I have seen this book everywhere. This book constantly gets recommended to me on my Amazon algorithm. I don't own a physical copy of this book yet, but the Bookish Box did do this as a subscription book pick, so I am waiting for my copy to be delivered to me. I am so looking forward to reading this book, and it also just got picked up by a publisher as well. I don't know how long this book series is gonna go for. I do know, however, this is a very thick book and very similar to what I said with A Kingdom of Flame and Fury. I have high expectations for this book based on the fact that it is thick, it's chunky, we've got a sequel out, and I'm just hearing absolutely amazing things about the ship. I'm so looking forward to this one and I cannot wait to let you guys know how we go with it once I eventually read it. And the next book I put on my 5-star predictions list is Bonded by Thorns by Elizabeth Hellen. And I'm so excited about this 5-star prediction for 2 reasons. Firstly, the author duo, Elizabeth Hellen, are coming to Babe 2025 and, well, actually, unless of course they cancel, but I don't want them to cancel. Oh my goodness, the cancellations for Babe 2023 were a little bit ridiculous. I really hope that Elizabeth Hellen make Babe 2025. Secondly, this is a Beauty and the Beast reimagining. But it's not just a Beauty and the Beast reimagining, it's a Beauty and the Beast Why Choose reimagining. Which honestly, besides The Beast by Katie Robert, where that was a Polly situation, I don't think I've ever read a Why Choose situation when it comes to the Beauty and the Beast. I'm very much looking forward to this one because Beauty and the Beast, that's enough to sell me on a book. If a book is a Beauty and the Beast reimagining, that is definitely enough to sell me on a book. I cannot wait to read this one and let you guys know how I go with it. I really hope I love it. I've been hearing great things and I've had this one personally recommended to me a few times, especially because I constantly talk about how much I love Beauty and the Beast and they're like, yeah, okay, you need to read this one. I seriously need more Beauty and the Beast in my life, please and thank you. And the second last 5-star prediction I've put on this list is The Crown of Oaths and Curses by Jay Bree. I still don't own this book and it has been almost a year since it came out. It was initially meant to come out in March of 2023, I believe, and then it kept on getting pushed back and pushed back. I was meant to receive a Babe exclusive edition and I also wanted to purchase the original paperback as well. As I'm filming this video, I currently don't own the first book in the series, so that is probably why I have not actually started the series. But I've heard absolutely amazing things, even from friends who have not actually read the Bonds That Tie series, because the Bonds That Tie series seems a little bit dark and they're not really into Why Choose and stuff. They're like, oh my goodness, Grace, this fantasy romance is absolutely amazing. It's captivating. I need everyone to read it. I really need to do that, especially because I'm already a fan of Jay Bree. So essentially, I feel like I'm a hypocrite because I say I'm a fan, but I have not yet read this book. So I'm technically a fake fan. I hope to get to this one sooner rather than later. And last, but certainly not least, the final book series that I've put on my 5-star predictions list is the Duskwalker Brides series, or at least the rest of the books in the Duskwalker Brides series, apart from the first book, A Soul to Keep. A Soul to Keep was a last minute favorite of mine for 2023. I started A Soul to Keep in November of 2023, and then I proceeded to continue and finish the book in December, and it shot up to my top 5 of 2023. It is actually my favorite standalone I read last year. And honestly, as much as I wanted to put A Soul to Heal as my 5-star prediction specifically, I have personally heard that A Soul to Heal is not as good as A Soul to Keep, and some of the books are just as good as A Soul to Keep, or they're not as good. So I've decided to just accept the fact that maybe the entire series is not going to be a 5 out of 5-star series, but I am predicting that I will find another favorite in the series. I am predicting that I will find another 5 out of 5-star book in the series. It might be A Soul to Heal, or it might be A Soul to Touch, or A Soul to Guide, or A Soul to Revive, or one of the other 4 books that are coming out in the series. Yes, guys, this is going to be a 9-book series, okay? I've got plenty of juicy content on the way for me. This series, I just know, is going to be a favorite series of all time. And I'm not going to lie, I am unsure about the rest of the series. I honestly don't know if any of the books are going to top A Soul to Keep, because Rhea and Orpheus, they are honestly so beautiful. They live in my mind rent-free. I cannot stop thinking about them, and I just want that same emotional connection to more characters in the series. I'm hoping to experience that with the characters we meet sometime later in the series. Fingers crossed I do. If I don't, I'll have to live with that, but I am expecting that at least one more book in the series will be a 5 out of 5 stars. That's for sure. So I guess that's gonna be it for this video today, book lovers. If you happen to stay till the end of the video, leave me the blue heart emoji. And if you happen to enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet already joined the amazing community of book lovers. And also, I have social media. I'm at GSwizzleBooks on Twitter and Instagram, and I'm also at Goodreads. That's www.goodreads.com/GSwizzle. And finally, I'm at TikTok. I'm at GSwizzle on TikTok if you want to follow me there for some bookish content. I love you, book lovers, and I will see you later. Peace. How did I weigh half when I flipped it in a double?